Hello and welcome back to Cap Tech. Today we're going to talk about 15 things that you didn't know about Ottawa, Illinois. And I even know what you're thinking. You're thinking, Cap, how do you know what I don't know? Well, as an Ottawinian, I know the mind of the average Ottawinian pretty well. So bear with me a second here. Here's my deep dive into the Ottawinian psyche. Are your property taxes too high? Did you think Riverfest was a music festival and were seriously disappointed last year? Last time you went out to breakfast, was it owned by Greeks, the restaurant? Do you think it's normal that one third of the businesses you go to don't take credit or debit cards and it's almost 2020? Do you pass at least two churches and two bars everywhere you drive to ever? Do you sometimes wonder if they'll really give you a ticket for turning left out of the Ottawa McDonald's drive-through parking lot? Do you rejoice in our newfound sushi, microbrewed beers, gourmet pizza, etc., but yearn for the days before we had a visible homeless population? So let's start out with the low-hanging fruit, shall we? Did you guys know that the guy that created Zorro was from Ottawa? I've covered it in previous videos. Did you know that we had a concentration of, a propensity of auto parts stores all within a few block radius, just in case you had to walk and go to like five or six of them? And then did you also know, also among the low-hanging fruit covered in previous videos, that we have a Lincoln Douglas statue and a Lincoln Douglas park, but that the statues of Lincoln and Douglas are actually in Washington Park? So those are your first three rarely known facts. But you're not expected to just sit back and listen to my psychobabble today. I have a few different categories of Ottawa facts, such as the bars, history, geology, and geography. And I've got a different co-host to bring you each one of these categories. So let's dive into the other 12 facts, shall we? Seriously though, folks, before my cheap ass hands this off to my co-hosts, I wanted to do a quick commercial for Cap Tech Studios, your hometown video studio. Create your custom-made videos in traditional video, whiteboard animation style video, or hybrid style. Please reach out today to captechstudios@gmail.com or CapTech on Facebook. Now back to the program. So as promised, we're out at the bars for facts 4 and 5. I'll give you fact number 4 that you didn't know about Ottawa. Jacob C. Zeller founded the Zeller Inn and Court Place Tavern in 1871 at 615 Columbus Street. But the original Zeller Inn was demolished in 1982. The Zeller Inn Tavern, originally known as Court Place, still remains, now called the Zeller Inn. The courtyard patio area on Columbus Street is where the original Zeller Inn stood. I'm going to hand it off to one of my last Ottawa buddies, Rockhard, to give us fact number 5, also on bars.
The fifth thing you probably did not know is our historical propensity to name bars with the initials LL. Want examples? How about the Limo Lounge, the Lazy L, and of course the Lamp Lighter, also known locally as, get this, the Limp Lifter, also LL.
Hi, I'm Ed Cap, leader of the local Spandex Mafia, and I'm going to take you through the history portion of our program today. Facts number 6 through 9, specifically kids. Sorry, life is not all sunshine and rainbows, kids. Fact 6 is that Ottawa had a stop on the Underground Railroad at 210 West Prospect Avenue. Fact 7, Ottawa was the site of a famous 1859 extrication of a runaway slave for violating the Fugitive Slave Law. 8, in 1910, William Dixon Boyce, then a resident of Ottawa, incorporated the Boy Scouts of America. But did you know 5 years later, also in Ottawa, Boys incorporated the Lone Scouts of America? Boys felt the Boy Scouts did not do enough for rural kids. Number 9, the last history fact. You know, Ottawa was the site of the first Lincoln-Douglas debates in 1858, but at our debate Douglas openly accused Abraham Lincoln of forming a secret bipartisan group of congressmen to bring about the abolition of slavery.
I'm CapTech's friend Clinky. I wanted to cover the geology facts because I rock. Fact 10, because of numerous silica sand deposits, Ottawa sand was on board the ill-fated Columbia space shuttle for experimental purposes. Number 11, with looming lawsuits, Radium Dial closed in 1936 but then reopened in 1937 under the name Luminous Processes in another part of town. Luminous Processes remained in operation until 1978. Fact 12 is that Ottawa has 16 areas that are still radioactive. A score of 28.5 or higher qualifies an area for the Superfund National Priority, and Ottawa has a score of 50, which is almost twice the minimum level for a Superfund site.
Hi, I'm nice guy Tom from St. Louis. I used to visit Ottawa annually until the 2019 Riverfest Fest debacle. I like to say that although geology may very well rock Clanky, but geography is where it's at. Like literally, fact 13, Ottawa has a suburb named Stoneyville but nobody ever talks about it, CapTech. Maybe that should have been in the low-hanging fruit section. Coming in at number 14 is that Ottawa is the largest city in the second largest county in the entire state of Illinois. Nice guy Tom out, if that's okay with you Ottawa folk. Call me when you get the bands back to the River Festival.
You know, I'll take us home with the 15th fact that you probably didn't know about Ottawa, Illinois. And that is that our population actually peaked historically with 19,400 in 1960. We're currently at 18,700, so a census or two from now we will probably catch that. But by the time we do, we will have nearly doubled the total population of America since 1960, which was about 180 million. So essentially, even by staying the same population, representatively, we're half the percentage of America that we used to be, or just about, by the time we get to our highest population since 1960. So stew on that for a while, math heads. I said math, not math. Don't get agitated, Ottawa. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please watch, share, comment, and subscribe. As a bonus fact, here you get to see demonstrated the Ottawa Shuffle. Thanks for watching, everybody. And that's a wrap, Ottawa.